Everyone wants to live in a world full of unicorns. Now, new fossil evidence suggests that humans actually did, so long as you're willing to accept Elasmotherium sibiricum as your elegant spiral-horned wonder horse. What we're talking about here is a prehistoric one-horned Eurasian rhino, one of three known species in the Elasmotherium genus. They're pretty remarkable in their own right, able to drive home a 6.5-foot horn with 3 or 4 tons of crushing weight. But experts have always wondered if ancient tales of the creatures might have informed our folkloric concept of the unicorn, both the delicate Western variety and its fiery Asian cousin. It's just one of many unprovable unicorn theories, but one huge problem was always the lack of overlap between Elasmotherium and Homo sapiens. We sprang up roughly 200,000 years ago, while previous estimates placed Elasmotherium extinction at around 350,000 years ago. But now a new study published in the American Journal of Applied Sciences puts the Siberian unicorn in the region of modern-day Kazakhstan a mere 29,000 years ago. According to Tomsk State University paleontologist Andrei Shapansky, this may have served as a refuge or last redoubt for the species, you know, until presumably Voldemort or those goblins from legend killed it dead. This paper resulted in a lot of unicorn-themed clickbait, but of course the idea that humans coexisted with Elasmotherium is pretty exciting on its own. I mean, maybe I'm a bit morbid here, but I'm more interested in whether one of these beasts ever skewered a Neolithic tribesperson. Heck, you could shish kebab a half dozen on that thing. Maybe Elasmotherium sibiricum did inspire tales of single-horned magical creatures. Or maybe the myth stems from profile representations of horned animals. Maybe it all comes from sightings of deformed goats or the nose-horned Indian or Javan rhino. Where do you think unicorns come from? Let us know, and if you crave more weird science wonders, be sure to explore now.howstuffworks.com each and every day.